il est venu le moment de clore cette journée sur Think, pour le moins, puisque l'Open World Forum continue jusqu'à demain. Donc, cette riche journée touche à sa fin. Et il me reste quelques points à mentionner et quelques remerciements à exprimer. Je crois que nous avons ensemble partagé un voyage riche et intéressant. Et pour cela, nous pouvons remercier chacun des 30 intervenants qui sont passés sur cette scène pour partager avec vous leurs connaissances, leurs recherches, leurs analyses et leurs opinions. Et on peut les remercier de leur temps, de la qualité de leur présence et de leurs interventions. Et grâce à eux, nous repartons enrichis, avec une vision peut-être un petit peu plus précise du visage de l'open source aujourd'hui et de ce qu'il sera demain, puisque c'était le thème à l'ouverture de cette session de Think et les questions que l'on se posait. On a également une perception des mutations qu'engendre l'open source dans différents domaines et différents champs. Et les champs des possibles qu'elle ouvre. Il y a un autre groupe de personnes qui a permis cette superbe manifestation de s'opérer. Ils ont investi beaucoup de temps, ils ont travaillé dur. Vous avez croisé certains d'entre eux lorsque vous arrivez et qui vous remettent leur badge. Vous avez croisé d'autres qui vous ont servi des cafés. Et puis, il y a tous ceux que vous n'avez pas vus qui sont derrière. Qui sont l'équipe de production, qui ont permis de relayer tout ce qui s'est passé sur cette scène, dans cette salle, dans tous les autres espaces de l'Eurosite, et également bien au-delà de cette salle, puisque nous étions présents et nous sommes présents sur le web. Donc, merci à eux également. Et pour terminer ces remerciements, ça fait des mois qu'ils se mobilisent. Ce sont toutes les personnes qui ont participé à, grâce à leur temps, leur savoir, leur réseau, leur connaissance, mettre en place ce programme auquel vous assistez et auquel vous pourrez assister encore ce soir pour Code et demain pour Code Experiment. Je fais référence au comité d'organisation de l'Open World Forum. Je crois qu'ils sont plus de 30 track leaders, mais ils ont sollicité beaucoup des membres de leur réseau, et c'est grâce à eux qu'a lieu cet Open World Forum et que cette quatrième édition semble se destiner à être un succès. Donc on peut les applaudir également et les remercier. Et enfin, je vais céder cette scène. Nous pouvons remercier généreusement les présidents de cette organisations qui sont cette année Jean-Pierre Lenné et Louis Montagne, qui sont les co-présidents de cette Open World Forum 2011, avec pour thématique Open Everything. Et je les invite à me rejoindre sur scène. On réservera les applaudissements pour l'issue de leur discours. Je vous demande d'accueillir Louis et Jean-Pierre.
May I take one?
Okay, go ahead.
I go ahead? No, I need I need my post-it.
Thank you.
So we need to thank people first, because all this stuff wouldn't be there without those people, and we need to list them. First of all, I think we must thank Ministry of Industry. His presence and support was important. Paris region, City of Paris, Syntec, and W3C. I'm very happy to thank W3C, because we've heard along these three days that HTTP was the only standard for the cloud.
We also like to thank our sponsors, namely Red Hat, which has been a great sponsor. It's a diamond sponsor this year, so thank you very much, Red Hat. Altaway and Smile, the INRIA, Intel AppUp, Microsoft, Neo Telecom, SUSE, Cloud Foundry, Adacore, AF83 and Burstech, Capgemini, Oracle, Qualcomm, Ubuntu, and XWiki, Accenture, Alcatel-Lucent, HP, Jamendo, and Nuxeo. That's a lot of sponsors. Thank you very much. So, Jean-Pierre, we are talking about a lot of questions. Did you get the 42 answers to your questions?
So, yeah, what was the question, in fact? We said, what is the future? And what is the future of what? Of course, open source and internet. And when we spoke about normalization of open source, because we went from a few to many users and developers and things like that, I think the answer we got was, it's okay, guys. Why should we complain? Why should? Because that's the way it has to go. And the only thing that we measure really is that, and this edition was really really important for that, is we are at a cornerstone. I mean, 2011 is a cornerstone for open source because of cloud computing, because of Internet of Things. But what is sure for sure is that open culture, as it has been developed in many areas during these 2 days, is mainstream. And at least open science, open art, and thing like and internet and things like that. So, if you take just a minute to think about it, what has been said is quite simple. I mean, we, with the open source and the internet, we have a kind of intermediation platform for citizens, for developers, for politics, for culture, for education. And this platform is done with open source and internet facilitating all that, facilitating the mix. And the mix of people, the mix of ideas, and things like that. And, of course, with this platform, we also have new challenges. And new challenges is mainly we find out that cloud computing is there, okay, but is it open? Is it interoperable? And we have here some question. We need to work on that. We have this big challenge. Will open cloud exist thanks to what we're doing these days? So basically, I think what we can see from all the conversation we had is that now we understand that open source is not a geek or nerd issue or engineer issue. It's more than that. It expands all around. And Louis, I'm speaking under your control. What you think about some points you've seen also?
I've seen there's one point that is really interesting is that we need, and I don't think it's really only open source and free software, but in our industry, globally speaking, we need to make sure that we are of some interest and we are like engaging to have more women to work in our industry, because when you take a look at all the panels and all the summits, and especially if you go to the code ones, there are not that many women. And that's probably something we have to work on. The other point that is really interesting is that a lot of things are changing based on the new uses the people do on the digital stuff. So it's really changing the way we work and the way software is built. So this is the second point that we will probably address next year.
I think it's important. I mean, if we speak about mixing culture and also sharing knowledge, and it's important to have women being part of the venture, or totally. We miss half of the population at least. So yes, that's a good point. The other point that I think we can think in term of is in term of what we discuss about. Software is for humans, not only for machines. I mean, it's not software for software. It's software that can be helpful for humans and specifically when the worst can happen. And that's where we have a real value, and maybe not measurable let's say any other economical value, but a real software for humans. And that's, we discovered also during those 2 days that the future belongs also to a kind of a soft activism, okay, to make things happening. And in the old days, why we had to push and to put pressure on top of that, maybe in 2 days we have more tools to do things like that. Don't you think so?
Yeah, I think we have a lot of activists in open source, and there are a lot of debates that are really important for freedom, for a lot of things, globally speaking, for humanity. But the fight, if there is a fight, has become more soft, and it's now really strong and going forward smoothly, but really good. So that's one good point of what happened this day.
And what I saw also when I've been all around and discussing with people and things like that is a big message is the future, in fact, is yours. It is what you bring to the table. It depends on you. And so is also Open World Forum. We are counting on you to feed us with ideas, to feed this forum with participation and sharing what you think would be interesting. So this is a message for you, I mean, to bring what you have to do. And finally, while all this is about motion, I mean, how do we move in the future, and emotion, I mean, how do we share things with other people, I must add personally, and I think I also share that with you, that I particularly love these days when we have the opportunity to meet and to discuss things and to build plans all together. So that would be, I would say, one of the main answers to the question we had. Yes, we have a future. We have a future for open source, and more than that, we have lots of great projects to build all together.
Totally. There's one point that has been really interesting is there has been a good political discussion at the beginning of the forum.
Surprisingly.
usually it's more like soft and smooth, and this year it has been really engaged. So maybe we have to work on a political track and include that in our forum. There's something really interesting happening today as well. I met a few people. There's the mix between think and code. And I met a few people that are developers and that went to the OSDC track. And they told me, you know, I've seen two ties in the track. And that was cool. They just looked interesting. And I met some guys as well that told me that, yeah, they went to see the t-shirts, and that was really interesting. They learned a lot. So the mix and the transition that we have between think and code, I think, is reconnecting the two worlds. So that's the first try that we do on that, but I think it's a good future.
Yeah, I think it's not finished, because I think the mixing party will start again tomorrow.
Yeah. So today, we're closing the think thread of the event, but tomorrow you will have code and experiment mixing up. And guess what about experiment? We just had an article in Lux magazine because of the 3D printer, the RepRap and the MakerBots. So that's really interesting how people get that. So please, if you have some time tomorrow, come and discover everything open source during experiment. So to conclude this fourth edition, we hope that you will participate. You will give us our feedback, like Jean-Pierre said. You will help us on the program and be there next year on the 27th of September to think, code, and experiment. And it's going to be the fifth edition of the Open World Forum. So thank you very much, Jean-Pierre. Being a two-headed president is cool.
Thanks a lot, Louis. And thanks to you to be there.
Merci à vous, messieurs les présidents. Donc voilà, nous voilà au terme de cette session de Think. J'étais ravie de passer ces deux jours avec vous. Il y a un dernier remerciement que je voudrais adresser, qui est à vous en tant que public, car c'est vous aussi, et principalement, qui faites l'Open World Forum. Donc merci de votre présence et de la qualité de vos interventions et de vos tweets. Je vais céder à présent la place à Code. Et pour cela, j'accueille Ori, à qui je cède la scène. Et je vous dis à bientôt.
Bonjour tout le monde. Donc, la...